So my topic is good morning to all of you, class 12th political science students. How are you? Hope you are all enjoying the life. Meeting you after so many days. I hope you have done your previous examination very nicely. And you will coming in the flying colors. Right. So today my topic is now second part going on. Challenges to the restoration of the Congress system. Challenges to and restoration of the Congress system. This is the topic, right? In this topic, you will find some cartoons are there. First year, see the first year cartoon. Here I'm enlarging the part. And in this is the introductory part of the chapter, the first year. Then second year, ninth year, then 11th year, then 22 years. First year, the Congress was galloping with a full swing. Daur rahi thi pure josh ke saath, Congress system and all. Ninth year mein thodi si hawa nikli, right? Thoda sa hal bura hua. To uske baad 11th, 17th year mein, कांग्रेस के हिस्से हुए एक आगे पूर्व की ओर गया तो एक पश्चिम की ओर गया somebody was going toward the east somebody is going to the west and the man who was holding these two buffaloes sorry the two oxes and they were he was unable to control the Congress system meaning the leader they were unable to control the system and see the after what happened after said 22 years see the Congress is fighting in between them And the man who was holding these animals, he's setting him setting a pillar, saving himself from the war of the Congress. So in this chapter, what we will do? In this chapter two, we read about the emergence of Congress system. We will read about the emergence of Congress system, and this system was first challenged during the 1960s. 1960 mein iska sa challenge hua. पहला चैलेंज शुरू हुआ एज पॉलिटिकल कंपटीशन यू शुड बी विद योर अलोंग विद योर बुक राइट कंपटीशन बिकम मोर इंटेंस द कांग्रेस फाउंड इट डिफिकल्ट टू रिटेन इट्स डोमिनेंस यहां पे दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट कांग्रेस फाउंड इट टू हैव द डोमिनेंस डोमिनेंस कर रही थी कांग्रेस नाउ इट्स अ डिफिकल्ट पार्ट फॉर देम इट फेस चैलेंजेस फ्रॉम द ऑपोजिशन That was more powerful and less divided than before, and the Congress was facing a lot of challenges from the opposition party. Look now, you know, in India, two parties, two section of the parties. You forget about the Congress party, you forget about the BJP, you forget about the Lok Dal, Janata Lok Dal, blah blah blah. Many parties are there, right? You forget every party. Now there are two. If we have got party system in India, democratic party system. One is an opposition party, one is the ruling party. That's all. Opposition party mein jo bhi whosoever the opposite of the ruling party, they are opposition party. One is the ruling party jo rule kar rahi hai. Basic things are these are two different. Opposition party will always pull the legs of na ruling party. या कुछ भी कर लो उसके उसके टांगों को खींचना ही खींचना वी कॉल इट इन इंग्लिश कॉकरोच मेंटेलिटी वी हैव टू हैव इट राइट सो 1960 के बाद इट फेस चैलेंजेस फ्रॉम द ऑपोजिशन दैट वाज मोर पावरफुल ऑपोजिशन वाज मोर पावरफुल देन एंड लेस डिवाइडेड राइट अर्लियर कांग्रेस पार्टी वाज नॉट डिवाइडेड एट ऑल दे वर ऑल यूनाइटेड Under Nehru and all, Gandhi Parivar. But now you see that what happened now. See, the opposition was more powerful and less divided than before. The Congress also faced challenges from within. Within का मतलब पार्टी के बीच में. पार्टी के बीच में से भी काफी opposition हो रही थी. किसके against? Of Congress के against. As the party could not no longer accommodate all kinds of differences. We know when a ruling parties there they have to you know accommodate lot of differences we have to accommodate right so basically the congress was unable to do that So this was one of the major problem for Congress. The Congress also faced challenges from within, as party could no longer accommodate all kinds of differences. In this chapter, we pick the story from where we left in chapter 2 in order to. अब हम इस चैप्टर को कंटिन्यू रखेंगे और व्हेन वी विल बी एबल टू कंप्लीट द चैप्टर वी विल एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ द पॉलिटिकल ट्रांजिशन टुक प्लेस आफ्टर नेहरू. आई टोल्ड यू जस्ट नाउ नेहरू वाज अ बेसिक लीडर ओवर देयर. मेनी अदर लीडर्स आल्सो टॉप लीडर्स होते हैं एट दैट टाइम. टॉप लीडर बिफोर 1960 टॉप लीडर्स वर हैविंग देयर ओन रेपुटेशन राइट. अर्लियर लुक नाउ द रेपुटेशन that time Nehru was enjoying at that at present Modi is enjoying. You know, Modi, suppose Modi is basically for BJP, BJP is for Modi. Same earlier, Mrs. Indira Gandhi for the Congress, Nehru for the Congress, right? Now again, Sonia Gandhi for Congress. So this all are from the Congress system. So they were facing a lot of challenges. Nehru was having that time was having a, you know, charismatic, you know, personality. But after Nehru's diminishing was there of Congress. Understand how the political transition took place. Political transition took place after Nehru. Nehru ke baad political scenario Congress ka kya hua? This is first we will be able to understand. This is the first point. नेहरू के बाद क्या हुआ, नेहरू के पहले क्या था और नेहरू के बाद क्या हुआ. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, मिसेज इंदिरा गांधी से पहले क्या हुआ, मिसेज इंदिरा गांधी के बाद क्या हुआ. राइट, नंबर वन. नंबर टू, डिस्क्राइब हाउ द ऑपोजिशन यूनिटी एंड द कांग्रेस स्प्लिट. पॉइंट नंबर वन, हाउ द ऑपोजिशन यूनिटी, ऑपोजिशन यूनाइटेड हो गया था. ऑपोजिशन वॉज यूनाइटेड किसके अगेंस्ट, कांग्रेस पार्टी के अगेंस्ट. कांग्रेस के अगेंस्ट ऑपोजिशन वॉज यूनाइटेड. दिस इज अ वेरी यू नो बिग पार्ट व्हेन समवन वांट टू आउटस्टेट द रूलिंग पार्टी. यू नो आई टोल्ड यू टू पार्टी सिस्टम्स आर देयर, वन इज ऑपोजिशन पार्टी, वन इज द रूलिंग पार्टी. रूलिंग पार्टी को आउट कैसे करेंगे, रूलिंग पार्टी को आउट कैसे करेंगे, व्हेन द ऑपोजिशन विल बी यूनाइटेड. Minimum differences will be there, and opposition party will successful to create lot of differences in the ruling party. खुद तो उन्होंने differences कम कर लिए opposition party में, लेकिन ruling party में बहुत सारे differences पैदा कर दिए. तो इससे किसको फायदा हुआ, opposition party को फायदा हुआ. पहले तो उसने क्या किया, they were started they uniting themselves, so opposition party was united. One, number two, they created lot of differences in the ruling party, right? So and the Congress, उसके बाद क्या हुआ, Congress split, Congress टूट गई कई हिस्सों में, Congress के टुकड़े हो गए, right? And posed a challenge to the Congress dominance. Congress ke party ke andar hi some people they challenged for the Congress system. Right. So next, we will be able to explain how a new Congress led by Mrs. Indira Gandhi, another a very prominent and known leader throughout the world, Mrs. Indira Gandhi. So how this party was dominated and controlled by this woman that was, you know, extraordinary personality of the Congress party, that was Mrs. Indira Gandhi. So Mrs. Indira Gandhi overcome these challenges. Now, how we say this is that a very successful, you know, Prime Minister of India, still we remember Mrs. Indira Gandhi. She gave a slogan, Garibi Hatao. And opposition gave what the slogan mean, Garib Hatao. E ko kaat dijiye, Garib Hatao. So this is the challenges. So how this Mrs. Indira Gandhi faced these challenges and how she was able to overcome. So explain, we will be able to overcome, explain how a new Congress led by Mrs. Indira Gandhi, she overcame these all type of challenges. Right, then we will be able to analyze the work of Mrs. Indira Gandhi also. We will be able to work of Mrs. ने सम कुछ तो काम किया हुआ है ना जो आज तक हम उनको याद करते. For example, I tell you about 1971 war. 1971 war जो पाकिस्तान के साथ हुआ था. She was the only leader. Due to her, we were able to give a good slap on the face of Pakistan, and we divided, we snatch another part that was East Pakistan, we call it Bangladesh. Ek pure tukde ko humne alag kar diya tha, and that was due to two people. One, General Manekshaw, that was a military commander. He was a military commander, and Mrs. Indira Gandhi, the Prime Minister of India. How she was able to overcome all these type of difficulties, we will be able to explain in this chapter. Next and last one, the fourth part, we will be able to analyze how new policies and ideologies facilitated, how new policies and ideology facilitated to restoration of the Congress system ko restore karne ke liye ideologies kaise kamgar siddhi. Okay, so first we will be able to understand how the political transition took place after Nehru ke baad kaisa hua, kya hua political path mein. Number two, hum baat karenge opposition unity ki, that is much more important to ousted Congress party, aur uske opposition party ke ikatthe hone se kya hua, Congress party ko kafi bada jhatka laga, and Congress party was divided into many parts, right? Our dominance के ऊपर क्वेश्चन मार्क बन गया. नंबर थर्ड, हाउ अ न्यू कांग्रेस लेड बाय मिसेज इंदिरा गांधी ओवरकेम दीज ऑल टाइप ऑफ चैलेंजेस. तो मिसेज इंदिरा गांधी जब आई तो उन्होंने कैसे अपने इनको चैलेंज को एक्सेप्ट किया. नंबर थर्ड एंड नंबर फोर्थ वाज वी विल बी एबल टू एनालाइज हाउ न्यू पॉलिसीज एंड आइडियोलॉजीज फैसिलिटेटेड द रेस्टोरेशन ऑफ द कांग्रेस सिस्टम को दोबारा लाने में कैसे मददगार सिद्ध हुए. Okay, now first is challenges to and restoration of the Congress system. So one collage is there here. Collage is there, and collage is written, Mr. Prime Minister Nehru is dead. Prime Minister Nehru is dead. And a small box, it is written, 1 lakh way to pay last homage. Right. And third part is country stunned by sudden end. Achanak death se pura country stabbed reh gayi. Right. It means at that time, complete India was depending on Nehru and its Nehru's ideologies. Whatever Nehru used to say, the whole country used to follow. Right, maybe wrong, maybe right, it's another issue. But domination, complete domination was there. And after Nehru, coming generation, they think that the whole country as a part of Nehru's family. Right. So challenges of political succession mein kya challenges hue kiske baad, Nehru ke jaane ke baad. Prime Minister Mr. Jawaharlal Nehru passed away in May 1964. He had been unwell for more than a year. This had generated a lot of speculation, andaza. Speculation ko kya kahenge? Andaza. About the usual question of succession after Nehru. Same question started during the time of Mrs. Indira Gandhi. After Mrs. Indira Gandhi, who? So that time Mrs. Indira Gandhi was, you know, not a prime minister. Her father was prime minister. So they used to think that who will be able to take the chair of Mr. Nehru prime ministership? So after Nehru, who? But in a newly independent country like India, the situation gave rise to more serious question after Nehru what? After Nehru, okay, who is there? That question is also there. That question is not less of seriousness, but much more serious question is there that after Nehru what? Nehru ke baad kya hoga? नेहरू के बाद कौन है कौन होगा वो तो अलग है पर क्या होगा इस देश का they used to think like this that after नेहरू what second part second question समझ आ गया पहला question समझ आ गया होगा so second question is from serious doubts that make outsiders had about whatever India democratic experiment will survive after नेहरू It was feared that like so many other newly independent countries, India too would not be able to manage a democratic succession. Yahan pe hum rukte hain and we will discuss it. You know, when India was independent, so many philosophers of Western part, political philosopher, political, you know, thinkers, think tank, used to think, maybe England, maybe, you know, the people from England, the people of Western part of the of the world, they used to think that India cannot survive in a democratic situation. Why? Because India is having a lot of differences, lot of dimensions. Right, their differences are big. They have near about 1500, I told you many times, 1500 languages. Lot of religions are there. They cannot be united. They cannot be united. इकट्ठे रह ही नहीं सकते तो नेहरू के बाद उन्होंने सोचा बस अब देश के टुकड़े होने वाले जितने भी स्टेट है ना सब अपने अपने क्योंकि see अब what happened you know if you go to south south में उनकी अपनी भाषा है India is absolutely divided on the languages. पंजाब में पंजाबी है बंगाल में बंगाली है तमिल तमिलनाडु में तमिल है राइट हरियाणा में हिंदी है झारखंड में झारखंडी भाषा है वी आर एब्सोल्युटली डिवाइडेड ऑन द लैंग्वेज सिस्टम नो वन नो कंट्री इन द वर्ल्ड इज बीइंग डिवाइडेड सच लाइक दिस कहीं भी आप देख लीजिए वहां पे एक ही भाषा जो उस देश की भाषा है आप फ्रांस में चले जाइए आपको फ्रेंच पढ़ना पड़ेगा तो आप जापान में चले जाइए आपको जापानीज पढ़नी पड़ेगी आप चाइना में चले जाइए आपको चाइनीज पढ़नी पड़ेगी कहीं भी आप रशिया में चले जाइए आपको रशियन लैंग्वेज सीखनी पड़ेगी बट इंडिया एक ऐसी भाषा है जो इन कंट्री है जिसमें आप यू नो 14-15 कंट्रीज को तो हमारे हमारे कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एक्ट करती है कि आप किसी भी भाषा में आ सकते हैं So they thought that India will not be able to survive. So the second question arose from the serious doubt that may outsider had had about whatever India democratic was there, whether the Indian democratic experiment will survive after Nehru. Nehru ke jaane ke baad kya India mein democratic order reh payegi? It was feared that so many countries, newly independent countries, India too would not be able to manage a democratic succession. India mein democracy ho nahi payegi, India toot jayega, India will be divided in many parts, many countries. A failure to do so, it was feared it could lead to a political role for the army. As Pakistan was having, same will happen in India. India will be dominated by the army. And controlled by the army, dictatorship will be over here. Besides, there were doubts if the new leadership would be able to handle the multiple crises that awaited solution. There were lots of crises because you know, India was a newly independent country. When India was, you know, ruled by five countries. Portuguese up to from Portuguese, the last one you know, Britishers. French were there, Dutch were there, other people were there. So India was ruled by the five countries. India was a colony under the five countries. Right. So that, you know, we have lot of multiple crises. हमारे यहाँ पे बहुत सारे crises. Crisis many problems. And that awaited a solution. उन problem का कोई solution नहीं था. No solution was there. So all problems were awaiting solution. कि अब क्या होगा? इसका solution क्या है? One or two problems were not there. They are bundled of problems. The 1960 were labeled as a dangerous decade. 10 years is one decade. So 10 years continuous 60 का decade, 60 से लेकर 70 तक, और 70 के बाद 71 में war शुरू हो गया था पाकिस्तान के साथ. Right. So lot of difficulties we were facing. और 60 से लेकर 70 तक का पूरा 10 years we were facing difficulties one after another without any proper solution. That's why we call it dangerous decade. We label dangerous decade when unresolved problems like poverty, inequality, communal and regional divisions were there. Yeah. Right. So problems like poverty, जो अभी भी है, near about 25 crore people are still under the poverty line. Right. So inequality is there, communal and regional divisions are there, communal division, you know, lot of problems between Hindus and Muslims, communal crisis शुरू हो जाती है. It lead to the failure of a democratic project. इससे क्या होगा? हमारी डेमोक्रेसी को बहुत बड़ा खतरा होने वाला है, क्योंकि इफ वी बिकॉज इंडिया अंडर द यू नो लैंग्वेज पार्ट, इंडिया इज डिवाइडेड इन मेनी पार्ट्स. ये आप किसी भी स्टेट में चले जाइए, इंडिया इज नॉट यू नो यूनाइटेड, आपको लगेगा ही नहीं. साउथ में आप जाइए, आप यू कैन नॉट स्पीक इन हिंदी. So problem like poverty, inequality, communal and regional divisions, etc., leads to the failure of a democratic project or even the disintegration of the country, which I told you just now. Disintegration of the country. Integration, judna. Disintegration, tootna. तो लोग ये सोचते थे कि इंडिया के कई टुकड़े होंगे, एक आध नहीं कई टुकड़े होंगे. On the communal base, on the regional base, on the state base, on the language base, बहुत सारे टुकड़े होंगे. India cannot be united, but all were wrong. सभी गलत थे. India is still united. India आज भी एक है. ठीक है, हमारे अंदर you know बहुत differences हो सकते हैं, but still we are united and we will be united. Next is from Nehru to Shastri. Nehru se Shastri tak. Right? We will do it by tomorrow. Kal hum iske upar baat karenge. Till then, you take care and I will send you the homework. Right? And you revise this part. From Nehru to Shastri also, and from Shastri to Indira Gandhi, right? And we have completed today about what we will do in this chapter and what were the challenges of the political system, political scenario, right? And tomorrow we will do from Nehru to Shastri. Take care. Till then, have a nice time. Thank you.